a wedding expo.
We all have that one favorite fast food restaurant, the one that perfectly sums up what a relationship has become. What better way to thank them for what they have done for you and your significant other than by having your wedding at their establishment? Or better yet, inspiring your wedding after their decor. Here is our list of the top 10 fast food weddings.
You know I love weddings.
McDonald's.
Oh, we love McDonald's.
This fast food chain is no doubt one of the bigger fast food corporations. It has some of the tastiest food, and the desserts aren't bad either. However, McDonald's knows their worth, and they see the potential in themselves. So when they decided to launch McDonald's Weddings, it was, of course, a hit. All the way over in Hong Kong, that is. The mega company now offers those willing to travel to Hong Kong a dream wedding in a few of their locations. Let's take a step back and be real here for a second.
What?
McDonald's?
This is all in fun, something lighthearted. It's even a great option for those who can't afford a huge wedding, but still want to have an affordable get-together with their friends and family. There are four different wedding packages, ranging in price from $380 US for the happiness party to $1,275 US for the love forever party. The most expensive package includes venue rental for 2 hours, a pair of McDonald's balloon wedding rings, character gifts for 50 guests, 50 pieces of invitation cards and thank you cards, an MC, and even a McDonald's apple pie wedding cake display. There have been a few occasions where McDonald's weddings have taken place in the States. However, they are nowhere near as fancy as the ones in Hong Kong. Taco Bell.
At the wedding chapel, what about Taco Bell?
If you are one of those people who don't dive into a chalupa every now and then you don't know what you're missing. Taco Bell gets a lot of flack for basically being, well, Taco Bell. Nothing is ever good enough, especially when you have direct competition with places like Del Taco. But yet again, Taco Bell has managed to make a move that will have them standing out from the crowd. They have a chapel in Las Vegas, of all places. This chapel is also a functioning Taco Bell restaurant.
That's when Taco Bell throws all the breakfast food in the dumpster. Can't let that raccoon get all of it.
Imagine walking down the aisle lined with hot sauce packets. Yes, this is the real setup. Apparently, for $600, you get custom merchandise like a sauce packet garter and bow tie, just married t-shirts, champagne flutes, a cake, and a taco 12-pack. Don't forget to finish off your ceremony with a photo shoot in front of a painting of the bells of Taco Bell. Oh, and don't worry about your bouquet. You will receive a sauce packet bouquet that you must return when your wedding is done. As for the gentlemen, well, they get to wear a bow tie that has sauce packets printed all over it. White Castle.
Huh. Names are a little deceiving.
As if the people who created these little square burgers could get any better. That's right, White Castle will get you hitched, fed, and on your way to marital bliss. Way back in the early 2000s, the restaurant chain started allowing patrons to get married there. We have to wonder if this has anything to do with those Harold and Kumar films. Truthfully, it could be that one couple did it as a joke and it spun into a whole thing and now we have White Castle weddings. There is apparently such a demand for weddings at White Castle that the company now hosts a contest of who had the best wedding at one of their establishments that year. We aren't sure what it is that draws couples to this option, but White Castle is making a killing doing it.
If you can't get married in a real castle, why not get married at White Castle?
One of their most popular wedding days is Valentine's Day. In fact, in 2010, the restaurant chain began hosting contests in various cities, partnering with radio stations, where couples could enter to possibly win the chance to get married in a White Castle. The prize included a wedding cake, a photo package, and catering. So marrying at White Castle is in such high demand that you have to enter a radio contest. Wow, maybe they should open a new division at the head office. Event planning. It would be interesting to find out how much money White Castle has made over the years from hosting these weddings. Starbucks.
Hey, heard you're going to Starbucks. Could you grab me a tall flat white?
You got it.
Hashtag Starbucks Wedding is actually a thing on Instagram, and you will be shocked at how many couples are participating. There are over 100 photos with that hashtag, and it is only getting bigger. The buzz around the Starbucks wedding is something we can only assume millennials are making a thing. Starbucks doesn't seem to have any real plans around these weddings, like some of the other establishments on this list. They don't offer packages, and you get nothing free for inconveniencing the heck out of their day.
Suspicious weddings, Kabul, Starbucks.
In fact, most of the pictures consist of couples standing outside a Starbucks with drinks in their hands. But then there are the bold photos, where people pop over to Starbucks after their wedding to have a whole photo shoot. Yes, we are talking lights, poses, and taking up the big table. You know, the one where all the students gather to do their work. There is even a couple who reportedly showed up with a minister to get the job done. We can't blame them. Starbucks is woven into the fabric of this generation. At least people are putting a creative spin on their nuptials. Sonic Drive-In.
That's a wedding I would kill to go to.
Sure, at it now.
Now, normally, Sonic doesn't do this, or so they say, but for one couple, they made an exception. Somewhere in Ohio, a couple met working at a Sonic together. 10 years later, they took their love back to the place where it originally started. The whole Sonic staff helped to make this couple's day special. The young couple was certain they wanted to tie the knot where they met, no matter where that happened to be. At least this location held some kind of sentiment for them. The nuptials, however, were a little different. You know, to accommodate the lack of an aisle to walk down and the smell of burgers, fries, and shakes being cooked up to eat for free after the reception, we hope.
Free food right away.
They still had most of the typical stuff you have at a wedding, just in a different capacity. The ring bearer wore roller skates, and instead of walking down the aisle, the bride was escorted by her father down a sidewalk by the drive-thru. The couple officially got married by the menu sign, while cars honked in celebration as they drove by. Before you laugh this love story away, this Sonic may actually be the place to find your significant other. The manager who helped plan the wedding also met his wife there. Is this the next dating fad? Instead of internet dating, we can have drive-through dating. Denny's.
Steve, come on, we're going to the diner.
All-day breakfast, a hash to die for, and a wedding ceremony? People often count Denny's out as it's not IHOP, and they can get a lot of flack for the food they serve. Yet, this doesn't stop people from showing up and getting married there. Denny's, like Taco Bell, actually has a restaurant with a chapel inside of it. Yes, you guessed it, it's also located in Las Vegas. They take their wedding business seriously. Customers can go for a grand slam of a wedding ceremony. Although booking the chapel typically costs $199, this year Denny's is offering a $99 wedding package that includes use of the chapel, a silk bouquet and boutonniere, a champagne toast, and a certificate commemorating the ceremony. So, in case you were wondering, yes, this is a full-blown wedding ceremony where you will be officially married afterward.
It's actually a very nice ceremony.
If you miss the $99 special, don't worry. You can pay full price and still get one heck of a bargain for a whole wedding. That package includes everything in the Valentine's Day package, as well as use of the photo booth, two wedding t-shirts, a wedding cake made of Denny's pancake puppies, which are basically cake pops filled with pancakes instead of cake, and a coupon for two original grand slams on the couple's next visit to Denny's. If they throw in an extra side of hash, we might consider hosting a wedding there. Breakfast for dinner is a fad that almost everyone loves, so hopefully these guests were into that. Burger King.
Whopper. Of a wedding.
One couple took the literal approach to their wedding. With last names like Burger and King, how could you not? In Chicago, a couple got Burger King to fund their wedding once they made their case that it was a match made in heaven. This couple fully embraced the idea by wearing the famous Burger King crowns. The bride had on a traditional wedding dress, which was beautiful, by the way, and the wedding party had some themed attire to celebrate the big day.
Liars!
Really?
Burger King?
The wedding party donned Burger King crowns for pictures, the groomsmen wore burger-themed socks and cufflinks, and koozies and mason jars adorned with logos decorated the tables at the reception. This is kind of a genius idea. A young couple can scrounge up enough to pay for some meals for the bridal party and guests, and spend a lot more money on a honeymoon they will talk about for the rest of their lives. What would be on your Burger King wedding wish list? Tim Hortons.
What in the name of Tim Hortons is going on here?
Usually, Canadians are more on the modest side. Not too flashy, and they certainly respect the heck out of Tim Hortons. One couple took that love of Tim's an extra step by having a Tim Hortons-themed wedding. In Calgary, the couple showed up at a local Tim's restaurant and just started the ceremony. The patrons of the restaurant were a bit confused. The pair exchanged vows in front of about 50 family members and friends, and several bewildered Tim's customers. The pastor was wearing a referee jersey, and the bride and groom engaged in some kind of hockey fight.
Clearly Canadian.
Oh, Canada. The wedding favors? Tim Hortons gift cards and customized hockey pucks that say, "We played, we scored, always and forever." The couple served guests coffee and Timbits. The ceremony concluded with the pair exchanging jerseys. Wow, sounds kind of fun to watch, to be honest. KFC.
If you like it, then you should really put a wing on it.
This salty, seasoned chicken was perfectly fine for one couple's wedding reception in Australia. For years, the tradition for this couple would be to play rugby and go out for KFC afterward. At one point, the bride started collecting the chicken buckets, hoping to include them on her wedding day. She notes that a lot of her family and friends thought she was crazy, but she did not disappoint. The buckets were all over the wedding reception. They even served more KFC for dinner.
What the fuck?
However, this couple took it one step further. They didn't only save their favorite chicken for their wedding day, they also ended up getting pregnant, and surprise, surprise, they served KFC at their baby shower as well. This is dedication if we've ever seen it. KFC is more fitting for a baby shower, and it can certainly accommodate a large group of people. The fact that this couple is so grateful to the fast food chain for being a special spot to them is kind of cool. And don't assume that they are only doing this because of a lack of money. The bride is a doctor. She just loves the sentiment behind it, and so do we.
KF, see you later.
Waffle House.
You look Waffle House handsome.
For many people, Waffle House was that late-night spot that you hit up after a night of partying. The food isn't that great, but no one notices that when they are not in the right state of mind. And many aren't picky when they can get, like, three dishes off the menu for under $20. In Florida, one couple took that late-night spot and turned it into a wedding venue.
I'm a Waffle House guy. You gotta stay in touch with that.
The couple admitted that Waffle House has no real sentimental value to them. All they wanted was to have a low-key, fun wedding, and they did just that. They weren't picky about attire, and they made sure their guests weren't either. When asked about the dress code, the bride told her family and friends, "I was like, y'all, it's Waffle House," meaning show up with whatever you can stand wearing for a few hours. The idea of having a wedding at Waffle House is kind of baffling, but honestly, food is one of the biggest costs of a wedding, and no one hates breakfast for dinner. So, there you have it. Would you consider a fast food-themed wedding?
Yes. Fast food.
Why go anywhere else? Tap that screen to check out another one of our great videos. And if you're here for the first time, then show us some love too and bang that subscribe button and bonk that bell to join our notification squad.